I'm Kristen Kindrachuk. I'm a visiting fellow from Canada at the National Institutes of Health in the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Disease, and I study fibrosis. So most people think of fibrosis as something that happens when they've got an injury. So in a joint, they'll get a buildup of scar tissue and it makes it really stiff and painful. But that happens in a lot of organs in response to infection or allergy. And so that's what we really focus on, is the fibrosis, the collagen buildup that you get in the organs that causes them to malfunction. I got involved in science a lot earlier on, before I really knew that was what I wanted to do. When I left high school, I wanted to do everything, but science just sort of seemed like a natural path. And it was after undergraduate when I got my degree in microbiology and zoology, where one day I was just reading the paper and there was an article about a local scientist and he was doing field studies on hantavirus, and it was like this light bulb just went off and I was like, that is what I want to do. I want to study infectious diseases. I did not come from a scientific background. My mother was a school teacher. She taught French and math and I believe Latin. And my father worked in accounting. So I do a lot of pipetting. I work in a tissue culture hood. I also do a lot of flow cytometry, which we use to look at immune cells and how that's affecting the immune response during a fibrotic response. Right now, there's actually no approved therapeutic for fibrosis. So what we're really interested in is understanding how different types of fibrosis differ. As I mentioned, a lot of people think of fibrosis as something in the joint, but we look at different organs, whether it's the liver or the lung or the heart, and we're trying to understand how these signals are directing fibrosis, and ultimately we'd like to find out how to intervene to prevent or to treat fibrosis, and in understanding how the different types are different, we might be able to find common therapeutics for different types of diseases or distinct therapeutics that we can use to stratify patients and develop a therapeutic to treat certain groups with one, certain groups with another therapeutic. We've already got a few drugs in the pipeline that are under development and seeking approval. So I do think we're well on our way to getting a couple of therapeutics approved. In 10 to 15 years, I would hope that we would see more therapeutics that would cover more of a broad spectrum of disease. So we could treat people with asthma or people with inflammatory bowel disease, where you see fibrosis as a result of these diseases. So my main advice is really just find what it is that you're interested in. You know, you might find great mentors, but you can't just adopt their interests. It has to be about what you want.
We'll be right back.